All right. Excuse me. So I'm Gary. And this is a Brinsea Ovation 56 XE. And you can hear that ticking, which I believe is the pump for the humidity control. So to change the pump, I've got this cover off. You're going to have to get it off of here because you got to have access to the pump. And at this point, I've also replaced that, this piece of tubing. You see how it's flattened out and it's been through a few hatches. Okay, disconnected the power. I've taken the access door off. It goes here. I've also removed the tubing. I have to take this inner cover off. Okay. This is a total of 8 screws. All screws are the same. The exception is the 2 center screws have washers on them. Do a little time lapse on this one. I'll point it out too. This is the best order to do this. The 2 center ones, the 4 corners, and then your 2 that hold the hold it to the center of the unit. And then reverse that order. When you put it back on, these are your 2 last ones. And there's a reason, a little reason. And for the record, my voice is really hoarse, a lot of allergies, and I don't normally sound like it, so this is what you get. You're lucky, it's nice and quiet. If you haven't cleaned your incubator, this is a good time to do it when this is all apart. We lock down with separate incubators, so these Brinseas are a little bit harder to clean, and they don't. If we just incubate them only, they're a lot cleaner. Save the mess for the other ones, it's easier to clean. But you still need to wipe these down occasionally. And this inner shell, you can wipe it all down, but just a damp rag is all you need. And then a soft rag to dry it with. It's not too bad right now. Okay, the motor and the fan, I'll point this out. On the older units, this was 2021 unit, and the gear for the egg turner was just fit on there by compression or pressure. The new ones this year that we bought, 2022. Now they have a screw that holds this on. Ours fell off, it was in there, and we were lucky to catch it soon enough. We didn't miss very many turns. I called Brinsea, they said just put super glue on it. So, now the fan also comes loose. So just remember the, now this is upside down. Just remember all the advertisement and warning goes down, which if you flip it goes up. Well, there, now you're confused. Okay, now the whole reason I had to take this off is this looks loose. Okay, I'm gonna have to. Okay, so the fan, both of these can be removed, and the motor. You can get over with these little needle nose. And there is a little lock right there, and it's, that slides. You get above that lock, and you should go there. So, just in case. Set that there. Anyway, the motor goes to the outside. We normally take a picture, but it's on video, so I won't worry about it. I think they're different sizes anyhow. A little bit different. So anyway, so we set that down. And one wire here is a little stronger, so I'm going to take that one loose. I don't need to remove this one, so it removes both. Let me hold it like this for a moment. Okay, so you can see what I'm doing. This wire here, this one gives you a little bit of slack. You don't really need to take that one loose, but this one you do. But, and I really don't want to either. Okay, I'll have to take this loose. In order to loosen that wire. Feathers on there from a previous hatch. Before we started locking down separately, that screw's a little longer, so we're going to set that separate. And let's see what we have. Oh, okay. This one actually comes to the back and to here. So I'm going to disconnect both of these wires so it's free. I have to cut the wire tie. And mark my wire. Do that first. And this wire, I don't have to mark. This is the only place you can go to. replacing that wire. And this wire. Now. Excuse me. This is what you had to be careful of. Those two wires disconnected. Now you can take these four screws off. Come off. Don't touch the circuit board with the face of it or underneath. Okay, there's your two wires. And the other two wires is connected to the pump. And this one, again, be careful with that. And so next, getting the pump out. Let's compare the new one. Everything looks the same. Brown bar goes back towards the two brown wires. Okay. It's locked. This is a little overkill, but this is what you want, so you can squeeze this lock. See if I can get this in. There's the lock right there. If you do that, then you should be able to pull it straight out. This pump onto the new one. So let's do that next. Hope they didn't super glue this. It's got flat bars or flat sides to it. Goes on that simple. Have to watch those O-rings. This goes on the locking side. Okay. These O-rings are really going to be a trick if they stay on. No. I'm guessing they got a little Vaseline or something on there. So this one's loose. So I'm going to place it directly on there. Start our wires first. Sure, that stays in place. So now, just want to make sure here, and it does appear to be centered. So we'll be all right. Okay, so the receptacle there fits right down in that slot. Seated at an angle. That lid is all cracked. Okay. Now, let's flip her back over. Now you'll be able to tell if the O-ring's seated properly. Don't know if you can see it. But there's an O-ring there. An O-ring there. And that's the O-ring that was loose. The two wires. Try going a little closer here. See if you can see it. Maybe. Anyway, the O-ring is centered back on properly. Just put it back backwards. Okay. Now. Brief the video. I wanted to make sure that I got my two plug-ins for the fan and for the turning motor in the correct place. even though they look a little bit different, the holes are larger on this one, they're still, you could easily mix them up. So, but the fan goes to this side, I mean, the motor goes to this side, the fan plugs in on this side. So I'm gonna plug that in first, the motor. I'm gonna use these little things here. Be careful not to bend my prongs. Okay. Now my fan, I need a little slack. Guess I could have cut that. But I didn't. So now, put the fan in place. Use it. The little lock slides right in the slot. This slot right here. So you can use that as a guide when putting it back on. Don't get too brutal here though. You'll feel it. Alright, so there that is. Now for this side. Looks pretty good. Just a little bit. There we go. Right in. Alright. And let's zip tie that first. I don't really need to. My connections there. Now, place the fan back. Everything looks good there. Advertisement down. A logo, whatever. There are some little points or something there, right here, fitting right in there. This gives you enough, gets you a good rough end. Okay, so now we'll replace our inner cover. Yeah, let me wipe that paint. Doesn't really look dirty other than that. So we'll go with it. Centered over there. Okay, inner cover. Slot for the motor. Flat side up. I'm gonna put it on. Center this. Looking at the fan, because remember the fan is loose. center it with the fan. And the motor falls in place. Now we screw it back on. Get the center first. Reverse order of what we did a while ago. Okay, I did replace that tubing. We have fresh tubing here. As you see, it's turning. There's no clicking. You can refer to your, you could just cut off the disc. It's probably not that critical. You see how flattened it's gotten. Or you could go to your book, and it has a cut guide. So, thank you very much for watching this. Again, my name is Gary, but this is, you'll usually see my wife Luann. I just do the fix-it stuff. So, this is Crazy Clucker's Farmstead. Like and subscribe. And again, thank you very much.